Yo, what's going on? Today's video, I really want to talk about Kawaki and kind of his descent to this path of, I want to say evil, but more so him wanting to willingly be taken over by Isshiki. Now, if you read the last chapter, chapter 51, spoilers by the way, if you're not caught up with the manga, but in chapter 51, there was a panel where amado and Kawaki were talking, and amado knows something was wrong with Kawaki, and Kawaki basically, to sum up the conversation, he basically felt powerless without the karma, and he started to feel worried that he wasn't going to get his karma back. Now, Kawaki is an orphan. Kawaki isn't special. He has nothing to offer besides being the vessel. He has no background. We don't know where he came from. He's not that strong. He's been getting abused by Jigen his whole entire life. So it kind of doesn't surprise me too much, because he's been powerless his whole entire life. So he now has this power that he's never felt before, but it comes at the expense that he has to become Isshiki's vessel. And I do find it interesting that he does want to get the Kara sign back. I think it's going to kind of I think that Kawaki is going to willingly show himself to Isshiki and get the karma mark on him. Because if we do know from the future that Kawaki and Boruto are fighting and he still has that mark on him, so that's a possible indication that Isshiki doesn't lose this fight that's going to be coming up in the next chapter. Isshiki does not die because his karma mark is on Kawaki. So sometime between now and then, Kawaki willingly gave himself up to Isshiki, or somehow Isshiki found his way to him, or some sort of way, but that karma mark gets right back onto Kawaki. And the reason why I said it's interesting, because if you guys remember, when they were showing us a little bit about Kawaki's past, kind of mentioned already that he was an orphan, but Jigen actually abused Kawaki very frequently. If you remember the other chapters, they're showing like Jigen beating Kawaki and just the mental and physical abuse that this man handles, and then it was crazy. And now Kawaki wants the power from his initial abuser because he feels powerless. So it's a really interesting dynamic struggle he's going through right now. But you can kind of see just how he might just start turning bad and kind of betray the hidden leaf. So yeah, so I do think that Kawaki is going to betray the leaf. Right now, I do think he is in a bunker with Amado, Sumire, and I believe Shikamaru too. Correct me if I'm wrong, I gotta look at the chapter again. But he's in that bunker down there where he's not supposed to be found or anything. So if he does have some powers back, maybe he'll fight and try to get out, but I highly doubt it, because it's built so Isshiki can't find him, right? So he's gonna either have to escape, run out of there, or something, you know? But yes, we are slowly seeing Kawaki just we're kind of seeing what his goals and objectives are going to be for the future. Now, in the first episode, I don't really know why he's attacking the village per se. From what we know right now, Kawaki's goals that he wants to achieve don't have anything to do with the Leaf Village at all. So I kind of think that something's going to happen in this altercation where Kawaki just has a hatred for the leaf. So yes, it does seem that Kawaki is slowly going down this path that he may not be able to come back from. I can definitely see him being or at least showing his true colors by the end of this chapter, because the leaf did house him, the leaf did protect him from Jigen and Isshiki, and Naruto and Sasuke are literally fighting to protect this man, and if he betrays them in any form, any which way, then that's gonna be, if I was Naruto, I'd be pissed off, because Naruto might actually die in this next chapter. And if he dies for nothing because this man Kawaki wants to turn his back on him, then it is what it is. But all I'm saying is they're fighting for you, they're fighting for Kawaki, so it'll be interesting to see how this kind of unfolds. And the last thing I want to mention is in the first episode of Boruto, Kawaki mentions that he's gonna send Boruto to the same place he sent Naruto. We don't know where that is yet, but may have something to do with this arc here. So, and it seems that it could possibly be Isshiki talking through Kawaki. So if in this fight, if Isshiki sends Naruto somewhere, then we definitely have some sort of confirmation that Isshiki is directly controlling Kawaki, and he has a lot of control over him. So yeah, that's all I wanted to talk about. Kind of just know, I noticed that in the last chapter that he was showing kind of his true colors, showing his true worries, and just want to talk about it because I think I did miss it in my review because I didn't initially see it, but I went back over the chapter and I kind of saw that, so just kind of want to talk about it. But I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Like, comment, subscribe, join the Discord and all that, and hope you have a good one. Peace.